Hi, this is Majinoni, and I got some in the mail today. It's the S.I.C. Masked Rider Deno Sword Form action figure. Here's the front here. And on the back, it just gives you some examples of the different poses that you can do with it. I already opened it, so that way I didn't have to spend 9 hours, you know, removing these tie things. But let's take a look at the figure, shall we? And the inside of the box just has the Deno symbol, and there's nothing else in there. There is an instruction manual, like so, and that's on the inside, right underneath, in between the cardboard there. Now, I really, like, I know I've said this multiple times, but I really, really like the S.I.C. figures. It's like it's that twisted version of the heroes. I really like the face. It kind of has this twisted, like, horn-like things up here. The chest plate is really well detailed. There's a lot of etched lines inside there. Even, like, when you look down here on the legs are really well detailed in that the lines are clear, distinct. They actually look like something rather than just somebody just threw a couple lines in there and that they wanted to call that a boot. The figure is fully poseable. You have your head can turn side to side. The shoulder pads go up. Arms go up. Arms can go around. Elbow bends. And the fist rotates. These things here on the side come off, like so. Knee, leg, twist, and your feet also bend. The toes do not bend on this figure. So if that's really important to you, then you're going to be out of luck with that. Now, the figure comes with a sword, two sets of hands, and these things here, they can go on the side. And it comes with that Deno card holder thing. Personally, I think I'm going to leave the card holder taped inside here because I know that's going to be the biggest pain in the ass later on. Now, with the hands, you'll get a closed fist type, not really closed, but it's something that you can actually hold on to something. In this case, this is the thumbs up, which Momotaro likes to do. And this is the one that you can grab the sword with. And on the other ones, those are going to be more traditional with your hand open type thing. Like so. For right now, I'm going to leave that in there. Like so. And let's see here. Let's take this one here. Now, the hands pop out really easy. All there is just a little ball-like knob, and there's a hole inside. Like so. You just pop it in, and it's good to go. And let's see here. Let's get the sword out. And then the sword just simply just slides into place. Now, this, like I said before, there's a lot of flexibility to the figure in that you can do a lot of different poses. You can pretty much, let's see here, you can pretty much mirror exactly like classic poses that Momotaro's would do. Like that one, like that. There's one here where he's holding the card. But, you know, like I was saying before, it's like, you know, with me, these things fall all the time. And when these things fall, because I don't have them in a glass case yet, any extra loose piece falls into a black hole. And, you know, I'm sure other people who get these toys can sympathize with that. It's like, it's always the tiniest piece and it just disappears. Even the sword manages to fly like 20 feet across the room, through a window, outside the wall type thing. But, oh, and here's the back. Yeah. So they didn't even chintz out on the back. You actually really have a complete, fully detailed action figure. My only... I don't really want to call it a complaint, because these figures are $10, and I think for what you get for $10, it's totally worth it. But I'm... Because of my decade figures that are much larger, I'm kind of spoiled with those. And I kind of wish this was the same size. I think if it was the same size as the other the decade ones, I would definitely have bought it. Because while I was skeptical of Deno at first, Deno became one of my more favorite shows. But yeah, definitely, if you have an extra $10 lying around, and of course, you know, there's postage and whatnot, definitely get it. It'd be a nice addition to your Kamen Rider collection. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to leave it on the side. And I still have the other Kamen Rider action figures that I still have to put up. So, until next time.